going to talk about accessibility in SAS Visual Analytics, and I'm going to show it along with the free SAS Graphics Accelerator, which is available in your Chrome browser for free. Accessibility standards include the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, which are the most widely adopted technical standards for digital accessibility. There are three levels: Level A, basic accessibility features; Level AA, the most commonly used level, and this is the level that SAS complies with. Products at this level meet a broad minimum threshold for accessibility. Products are accessible to users with a variety of abilities, and this level is ubiquitously accepted. Level AAA is the highest level accessibility, which is icing on the cake. SAS is constantly trying to improve our accessibility, and we currently are at level AA for WCAG 2.0. When my sister Shanna turned 44, her husband took her out to dinner at a nice Italian restaurant near Philadelphia in the U.S., and it was romantically lit with candles and a wonderful ambiance. When the waitress brought the menu, Shanna looked down at the menu and saw nothing but tiny incoherent scrawl on the page. She couldn't read a word. "This print is too small and this room is too dark," said my sister, who never shies away from commenting. The waitress looked at her knowingly and said, "Here, honey," and handed her a pair of reader glasses. Shanna put them on, and suddenly everything on the menu was completely legible. Accessibility and assistive technology is analogous to that pair of glasses. What was indiscernible becomes clear, and the goal of communication is achieved. This image shows a menu with tiny unreadable font, which is overlain with a magnified circle of large print legible text. A pair of reader glasses is lying rakishly at 2 o'clock next to the magnified circle. To give you a little background, visual impairment increases dramatically with age. Over 1 billion people, about 15% of the world, live with some form of disability, and almost everyone experiences some form of temporary or permanent disability at some point in their life. The World Health Organization identifies 4% of the global population as being visually impaired, 4% as having low vision, and 0.6% as being blind. Many others have temporary or permanent motor skill impairments that prevent them from using a keyboard or a mouse. In this image, I show that males tend to have lower visual impairment than females, and that males less than 50 have the percentage of visual impairment is about 3.37%, whereas females is 3.77%. After 50, about 10.5% of males have visual impairment, and almost 12% of females. SAS's target for accessibility is the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, which are defined by the World Wide Web Consortium. SAS R&D works to provide an efficient user experience for users with specific disabilities, including users with limited vision, users without the perception of color, users without vision, users with limited manipulation, and users without hearing. If you are a report designer, stop designing for only 85% of users. If you design with accessibility from the beginning, it is much easier than trying to retrofit it. So building a report with accessibility baked in is like building a house with accessibility features in the original blueprints. This image says, "Think ahead, build your reports with accessibility in mind." And on the left side shows an image with an elegant cylindrical glass elevator nestled in the center of gorgeous wooden floating staircase. And on the right, it shows a retrofitted chairlift retrofitted to a staircase, which should be used if needed, but if you can plan ahead, which is very easy to do with SAS Visual Analytics, design your reports with accessibility in mind from the beginning. There are a few examples of best practices that I'll mention here. Number one, keep it simple and avoid busy pages. This is a best practice for everyone. Include helpful notes at the beginning of a report. For example, include a note detailing how to override the report theme with the high contrast theme. Use accessible, friendly objects such as list tables, crosstabs, bar charts, line charts, geomaps, time series plots, pie charts, and word clouds. If you can't use an accessible object, or if you need to use an inaccessible object, be sure to provide the same information in an additional accessible form by either providing the same information in an accessible object, such as a list table or crosstab, next to the inaccessible object, or provide a hint in a text box about the details table that appears when you maximize an object. Provide meaningful identifiers for page names and objects, as I show here. Bar chart of visual impairment by sex and age group is much more meaningful than just bar chart 1, for example. Use colors with different luminosities for accessibility to colorblind users, as shown here. SAS will by default use these colors, but often designers will change the colors, for example, to match a logo or something for the company. So be very careful when you're selecting your own colors to try to make the different colors different luminosities. Be sure to leave a tip about using the high contrast override. As I'm showing here, you can see the hash marks have been added to the females and the males have no hash marks. So fill patterns can be very helpful. Even if you didn't use them in designing, these would be automatically applied by the user. So let me show you some important settings. Settings are available from the user profile, which is at the top right. And if you select settings, you can see global. And under global is general, region and language, and accessibility. If you select accessibility, you have the opportunity to enable sounds. Under SAS Visual Analytics, which continues down the list, you have interface, report defaults, geographic mapping, network analysis, visual statistics, performance, and themes. If you select themes, you can override the report theme and use the SAS High Contrast report theme. This a user can do regardless of what the designer did. So this is really nice. Also, let me F11 out of this Mac screen. See up here, this little icon that looks kind of like a hammer or perhaps a bat that says extensions. If I select that icon, I can see that I have SAS Graphics Accelerator. I downloaded this earlier from the Chrome Web Store. Under that, I have extract tables from this page, laboratory options, resources, and about. Let me select options and see here under auditory, I have enabled self-voicing feature in the graph view and map view. I've enabled web speech. You can see this can be either off or web speech. I don't need to save this because I did this earlier. Back to my visual analytics. Since I have this SAS Graphics Accelerator enabled, I have a lot of really cool things now that I can use. So let me go to my next tab in the report. Recall that you can use Control Page Up to change tabs in your Chrome browser, and you can select Control Right Arrow and then select Enter to change tabs in your SAS Visual Analytics report. So I'm going to do that now. I'm selecting Control Right Arrow and it becomes highlighted. And then I will select Enter and I move to that page. Here we can see sales rep percent of target at a discount store only. It's been filtered by discount store and we can see the different vendor types. We can see the fill pattern has been accessed because we are using the SAS Graphics Accelerator. Now, if I want to sonify this, I can. I will go to the object menu, which is these three ellipses, and I can view with SAS Graphics Accelerator.
Discount store, 136% plush.
So I have sonified this, and I've also enabled the graph to talk to me.
Sound submenu S.
Use sound off. chord or melody. I can also access this or toggle it by just hitting S.
Navigation, submenu, V, melody, off, chord, melody, off, chord, melody.
To change my web speech, I can select C.
Verbose.
Note that my graph must be selected. So I can select C again.
Off, terse, verbose, off, terse.
I prefer terse. So now I can change my group by selecting G.
Discount store, 108% thrift. Discount store, 93% figure. Discount store, 92% game. Discount store, 81% promo. Discount store, 69% gift.
I'll select control page up to go back to my accessibility report. Next, I'm going to select control right arrow and control right arrow again and enter. Again, I can sonify this. View with SAS Graphics Accelerator.
Discount store, 81%. Department store, 44%. Other, 42%. Convenience store, 36%. Kiosk, 35%.
There's also information down at the bottom of these graphs. For example, type bar chart, title, x-axis, y-axis, a little description. If you're using something like JAWS, this would also be read to you. You can save this page to a laboratory, or you could download the data as a CSV. There's also a data table here at the bottom right. So you can see there are quite a few accessibility features built into the SAS Visual Analytics, particularly if you download the free SAS Graphics Accelerator via the Chrome Web Store. I've just touched on some of these. Please visit the SAS documentation or contact accessibility@sas.com. I'd like to give a huge shout out to Ed Summers and thank him profusely. I could not have created this video without his assistance and handholding. For more information, see the links below or email accessibility@sas.com. I'm Beth Ebersole with SAS. I hope this was helpful.